Speaking of tragedy, did you guys know that they're going to remake the Titanic? Yeah, have you heard this? They're going to do a remake of the Titanic. Not the movie. Like, they're remaking the Titanic. Like, the boat. Not the flick, the ship, right? And that's insane. I think we can all agree that's insane. But the weirdest part is that they're calling the new boat Titanic 2. Which is kind of disappointing, right? That they're going to sink all this money into this new boat. And that's the best they're going to name it, like it's some shitty Hollywood sequel, you know? And then what's weirder is that somebody already did a shitty Hollywood sequel to the Titanic, the movie, in 2010. And that movie was called Titanic 2. And the plot of Titanic 2, and I swear I'm not making any of this up, is that a guy decides to remake the Titanic, like the boat in the movie. I know, it's very confusing. But in the movie, Titanic 2, a guy rebuilds the ship, Titanic, and they call the new Titanic, Titanic 2. But in the movie, see, in the movie, there's a twist, okay? The Titanic 2 doesn't hit an iceberg. What happens is on the maiden voyage, a tsunami occurs, and an iceberg is flung into the Titanic, like baseball. You know? So if you haven't seen this movie, don't, it sucks. Or do, because it sucks. But there's a couple reasons it's so bad. The first thing is that it was made on a $500,000 budget. Which, if you don't know, is not enough money to make a movie, okay? For reference, James Cameron's 1997 cinematic masterpiece, The Titanic, was made on a $200 million budget. Which means somebody had the idea to try to remake The Titanic on a quarter of a percent of the budget. Which is pretty ballsy, right? I think we can agree with that. And then they only released this movie in Australia for some reason. It's like, of course nobody saw it, you know? And it really made me think, like, who has the balls to try and remake the Titanic in this way, you know? So I did a little research. Turns out Titanic 2 was written and directed by an American filmmaker named Shane Van Dyke. Shane Van Dyke calls himself a mockbuster filmmaker. Yeah. Which basically means that he takes popular Hollywood blockbusters and then he makes a shitty, unauthorized remake, right? So if you go on his IMDb, you'll find him associated with such titles as Paranormal Entity or Transmorphers, which kind of sounds like a pirated version of Transformers, but it is somehow worse. And of course, his most ambitious project, Titanic 2. So I'm thinking, like, where does this Shane Van Dyke guy get the balls to try and remake Titanic? Turns out Shane Van Dyke is the grandson of living Hollywood legend Dick Van Dyke.
No.
That's right, everybody. Yes. Shane Van Dyke is Dick Van Dyke's grandson. That's where you get the balls to try and remake Titanic. You have to be Dick Van Dyke's shitty, shitty grandson. And then it starts to make sense, right? Like, it makes sense that Shane Van Dyke makes mockbuster movies because he himself is essentially a shitty Hollywood remake, right? But then it got me thinking, like, okay, that's all well and good. But then in 2012, 2 years after Titanic 2 was only released in Australia, a real-life Australian billionaire named Professor Clive Palmer decided he was going to begin construction on an exact model replica of the RMS Titanic. And you can go online and you can find all these, like, blueprints and layouts and computer models and all these testimonials with different shipbuilders and designers and historians, and they're talking about how it's going to be the exact same experience you'd have had in 1912. Like, it's almost as if they don't remember what happened to the Titanic, you know? Or in the Titanic. Or in Titanic 2. I don't know if I'm remembering it correctly, but I feel like it was not a good experience, you know? But here's the thing, gang, is that the Titanic 2 boat might not even get made. It was started in 2012, supposed to be done already in 2016, and then it got delayed to 2018, and it was delayed again to 2022. And the reason they keep pushing it back is because they can't find the investors to raise the money to finish the project. Now, as I've covered, I don't know most things, right? So I don't know anything about shipbuilding or finance or investing, but no shit they can't find the money, right? Like, who is going to buy a ticket for Titanic 2? What kind of deranged historian is like bringing a brochure home to their spouse like, look, honey, I know how you've always said you wanted to go on a cruise and die in the most bizarrely ironic way possible. Sounds like a plan. So it really makes me think, you know, like, Professor Palmer, if that is your real title, like, what are you doing, man? Like, what's the point? It's just, you know you're not going to raise enough money. You know you're not going to sell any tickets. It seems like you're just doing this just because you can, you know? Like, where do you even think that you can get the balls to try and remake the Titanic? Like, who do you think you are? Shane Van Dyke? Good, all you guys have been incredible. Thank you so much.